Jane Doe?
Yes, I am.
My name is Jessica Ryan. I'm a PA student here at the University of the Commons. Let me just get your name and your date of birth from you.
Jane Doe, and then 2/18/94.
Okay, and let me just make sure your MI number is correct. Perfect. Okay, so today we're here for a breast exam, pelvic exam, and pap smear, correct?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, please excuse me while I go wash my hands. So, to start the exam, we're going to start with the breast exam. So, the patient would be sitting upright and disrobed from the waist up, and we would have her fully exposed. And what I'm doing is I'm checking the symmetry and the contour of the breasts, and then I'm looking for any rashes or masses, dimpling, or any nipple discharge. So then I would go ahead, and after that I'd have the patient go ahead and lay on down. And I'm only going to uncover one breast at a time, just to make sure that she feels comfortable and she's not getting cold, because y'all know rooms are cold. So I'm going to expose one side, and I'm going to use my second, third, and fourth fingers, pads, in small concentric circles, using light, medium, and deep pressure in a symmetric pattern. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to start in the axillary area, and I'm palpating for any enlarged lymph nodes. And then I'm going to move on down to the bra line. And then I'm going to move in medially and palpate back up to the clavicle. And then I'm going to check the infraclavicular and the supraclavicular lymph nodes. And then I'm going to go back to where I left off. And I'm going to palpate down from the clavicle to the nipple. And then I'm going to continue from the nipple down to the bra line, and I'm using a vertical overlapping pattern. And I'm going to do this all the way to the mid-sternum. And then I'm going to palpate the nipple to make sure that there's no nipple discharge, and checking the elasticity of the nipple. So that is it for our breast exam. And now I'm gonna go ahead and move on to the pelvic exam. So I would go ahead and ask the patient if they needed to use the restroom. And if they did, they can go ahead and do it. And then I'm gonna go ahead and have them laying down with their head and shoulders supported by pillows and their arms at their sides. Then I'm gonna drape the patient from the mid-abdomen to the legs, or to the knees, and then I place them in the lithotomy position. So I'm going to tell the patient, all right, we're going to put your feet in the stirrups. And when I say feet, I mean put your heels right here. And then I'm going to go ahead and have you move your butt all the way to the edge of the table. And then the thighs are going to be flexed, abducted, and externally rotated at the hips. And then I'm going to make sure that I depress the sheet so that I can see and talk to the patient. I'm going to go ahead and take a seat. And I'm going to warn the patient that I'm going to be touching them. So I'm going to be like, hey, my hand's going to touch the inside of your thigh, and then I'm going to be touching your pelvic area. So usually this would be up like this so I could see, but that's not going to work. So we're going to go like this. All right. So the first thing we're going to do is just find some landmarks on the outside of the body. So we have the monus pubis, the labia, and the perineum. And then I would split the labia and look at the clitoris, the urethral meatus, and the introitus. And then I would go ahead and start the speculum exam. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to warn the patient that this is the speculum exam. And I'm going to find the correct size speculum for the patient and run it under some warm water. And then I'm going to depress the introitus with my finger. And I'm going to take the speculum in, and it's closed. And I'm going to insert it into the vagina, and I have my finger down on the introitus to ease insertion, and then with my hand I'm also going to use it to split the labia to make it just a little bit easier to insert. And as I'm inserting the speculum, I'm keeping a posterior and downward slope to keep that introitus relaxed. And then once I have the speculum all the way in, I'm gonna go ahead and release my finger on the introitus, but I'm keeping a downward pressure to keep it relaxed. So now I'm gonna move it into a horizontal plane, keeping that posterior pressure, and I'm going to make sure it's inserted fully. And then I'm gonna go ahead and open it up and make sure that the cervix is cupped in the speculum. And I would make sure that my light source, even though it doesn't work, is on and correct. And then I'd move it and adjust it if I need it to. So then I'm gonna lock in the speculum, but not prematurely. And then I'm going to go ahead and start the pap smear. So I'm going to grab the cervical broom and I'm gonna stick it in the cervix and I'm gonna move it in a clockwise direction both ways fully. And I'm looking to get epithelial and columnar epithelial cells on the cervical broom. And I'm gonna put it directly into the preservative and then send this off. So now that we've done the pap smear, I'm gonna go ahead and release the speculum, but I'm gonna maintain it open with my thumb. And as I'm pulling the speculum out, I'm going to be looking at the vaginal canal. And then once I pass the introitus, I'm gonna go ahead and let the speculum close, making sure not to pinch any mucosa or stretch the mucosa. And then I'm gonna note the color, inflammation, discharge, ulcer, or masses in the vagina. And then I would go ahead and move on to the bimanual exam. So now I'm going to stand while I was sitting for that part. And I'm going to go ahead and, with my gloved hands, I'm going to lubricate my index and middle finger. And I'm going to insert them into the vaginal canal posteriorly. And I'm keeping my pinky and my ring finger flexed against my hand and my thumb abducted. Once again, I'm pushing posteriorly to keep that tortoise relaxed. So now I'm gonna feel for the cervix. And the cervix, I'm checking for the position, the shape, if there's any tenderness or mobility, and noting that the cervix can sometimes be tender and that can be normal with movement. And then I'm gonna check the fornices around the cervix. And if there's tenderness in that and the adnexal structures, it can be indicative of PID. So now that I've looked at both of those, I'm gonna try to palpate the cervix and the uterus. So what I'm going to do is I'm gonna turn my fingers around and I'm gonna push up on the cervix and the uterus with my examining hand, and with my abdominal hand, I'm gonna go halfway between the umbilicus and the monus pubis, and I'm gonna push down while pushing up. And what I'm trying to do is trap that uterus and cervix against my hand so I can feel if there's any masses or abnormalities in there. So now that I'm done with that, I'm gonna go ahead and just move over to the right lower quadrant with my abdominal hand, and with my examining hand, I'm just gonna move over to the lateral fornices. And I'm gonna push down again, and this is checking for ovaries. So I'm pushing up in the examining hand and pushing down in the abdomen exam. And if I feel an ovary, that's normal. But if you feel any other masses, it could be a tubo ovary abscess, sulpingitis, or an ectopic pregnancy. And so when I'm done with that, I would just go ahead and repeat it on the left side. And then that is it for the bimanual exam. And so now I'd move on to the rectovaginal exam. So I would change my gloves and re-lubricate my fingers. And I'm gonna stick my index finger in the vagina and my middle finger in the anal canal or anal vault. And I would ask the patient to bear down, and really what this does is just relaxes the sphincters. And they may feel like they need to void their bowels, but just reassure them that it's not gonna happen and it's okay, it's normal. And then what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna push anteriorly and lateral with my examining hand, and I'm gonna push down with my abdomen hand so that I can feel the structures. And then when I'm done with that, I'm gonna withdraw both hands. I'm gonna take my index finger and I'm gonna go into the anal vault, and I'm gonna do a sweep to make sure I can't feel any masses. And then that concludes the anal vaginal exam. And I'm going to leave some wet wipes or some tissues in here so that the patient can go ahead and clean themselves up after the exam. All right, Jane Doe, do you have any questions for me? All right, perfect. Have a good day.